Mr. Gruff, do you know what sport is known as America's great pastime?
That's easy. Pitching horseshoes.
Well, I'm afraid not, Mr. Gruff. Just about everybody knows that America's favorite pastime is baseball. And since it begins with a B, suppose we listen to a wonderful poem about baseball. Casey at the Bat. It looked extremely rocky for the Mudville Nine that day. The score stood 2-4 with but an inning left to play. So when Cooney died at second and Burroughs did the same, a pallor wreathed the features of the patrons of the game. Straggling few got up to go, leaving there the rest with that hope that springs eternal within the human breast. For they thought, if only Casey could get a whack at that. They'd put even money now with Casey at the bat. But Flynn preceded Casey, and likewise so did Blake. And the former was a puddin', and the latter was a fake. So on that stricken multitude a death-like silence sat, for there seemed but little chance of Casey's getting to the bat. But Flynn let drive a single to the wonderment of all, and the much-despised Blakey tore the cover off the ball. And when the dust had lifted and they saw what had occurred, there was Blakey safe at second, and Flynn a-hugging third. Then from the gladdened multitude went up a joyful yell. It rumbled in the mountaintops, it rattled in the dell. It struck upon the hillside and rebounded on the flat. For Casey, mighty Casey, was advancing to the bat. There was ease in Casey's manner as he stepped into his place. There was pride in Casey's bearing and a smile on Casey's face. And when, responding to the cheers, he lightly doffed his hat, no stranger in the crowd could doubt. 'Twas Casey at the bat. 10,000 eyes were on him as he rubbed his hands with dirt. 5,000 tongues applauded when he wiped them on his shirt. Then, when the writhing pitcher ground the ball into his hip, defiance glanced in Casey's eye. A sneer curled Casey's lip. And now the leather-covered sphere came hurtling through the air, and Casey stood a-watching it in haughty grandeur there. Close by the sturdy batsman, the ball unheeded sped. "It ain't my style," said Casey.
"Strike one,"
the umpire said. From the benches black with people, there went up a muffled roar like the beating of the storm waves on a stern and distant shore.
"Kill him! Kill the umpire!"
shouted someone in the stand, and it's likely they'd have killed him had not Casey raised his hand. With a smile of Christian charity, great Casey's visage shone. He stilled the rising tumult. He made the game go on. He signaled to the pitcher, and once more the spheroid flew. But Casey still ignored it, and the umpire said,
"Strike two! Fraud!"
cried the madding thousands, and the echoes answered,
"Fraud!"
But one scornful look from Casey, and the audience was awed. They saw his face go stern and cold, they saw his muscles strain, and they knew that Casey wouldn't let the ball go by again. The sneer is gone from Casey's lips. His teeth are clenched in hate. He pounds with cruel vengeance his bat upon the plate. And now the pitcher holds the ball, and now he lets it go, and now the air is shattered by the force of Casey's blow. Oh, somewhere in this favored land, the sun is shining bright. The band is playing somewhere, and somewhere hearts are light. And somewhere men are laughing, and somewhere children shout. But there is no joy in Mudville. Mighty Casey has struck out.